students, welcome to HP Kapilya School. I am Nisha James and I am taking biology practical. Today we are going to do the 4th 11th standard biology practical, that is the biochemical test for starch. Okay, so in this biochemical test for starch, you have to perform two tests. First one, iodine test, and the second one, ring test. So these are the two tests we are going to perform, and how to perform this test that I am going to tell you now. So students, now I am going to tell you how to perform the biochemical test for starch. So this is a starch solution. I have already prepared the starch solution. Now, what are the reagents we need for this practical? First one, we need iodine. So this is iodine. Okay. Now, this is alpha naphthol. And the third one is H2SO4. So, along with starch solution, these are the three reagents we need for this biochemical test. Now, I am going to start the practical. So, as I already told you that we have to perform two tests in this practical. First test is the iodine test. So, I will tell you how to perform iodine test. First, you have to take the starch solution in a test tube. You have to take 3 ml of the starch solution. So I have taken 3 ml. Now you have to add iodine with help of a dropper. This is called dropper. With help of this dropper, we can put the solution drop by drop. So we have to add 2 drops of iodine solution. 1, 2. After adding iodine solution, you have to shake the test tube. When you shake it, you can find that we are getting a bluish color PPT. So this is the indication of starch in our solution. Okay, sometime in examination, in your board examination, okay, you are not provided, when you are getting a sample, in that sample it is not written whether it is starch or protein. So you have to identify your particular solution, what is present, starch, protein, by this test. So, when you are getting the solution, immediately you have to put iodine. So, if you are getting bluish black PPT, that means starch is present in your solution. So, this is one of the confirmatory tests for starch. Now, we are performing the second test of the starch, that is ring test. So, for this, first we have to take a test tube. Then we have to add 3 ml of the solution. So, I have taken 3 ml of the solution, almost this much. Now, we have to add 2 drops of alpha naphthol. Okay. So, this brown color solution, this is called alpha naphthol. Okay. So, with help of the dropper, I am adding 2 drops of this. 1, 2. Only 2 drops, otherwise the color will be more darker. Now, you will get a light brown color. Now in this, we have to add concentrated H2SO4. How to put this concentrated H2SO4 is very, very important. First, you have to keep the test tube in a slanting position. Then you have to add the concentrated H2SO4. With help of the dropper, you have to take it. Okay. Now, continuously you have to add this concentrated H2SO4. This is concentrated, that's why the fumes are coming out. Now, after adding concentrated H2SO4, you please tilt the test tube in a straight position. You can find one brown colored ring. Okay, I will show you the ring. Okay, so you have to handle the ring very carefully. If you shake it too much, what will happen? The ring will break. So, this is ring test. Okay. So, ring test is another confirmatory test for starch. Okay. So, this is the biochemical test for starch. So, today we have learned that I have performed two tests. First one, I told you iodine test. In that, I have taken 3 ml of the starch solution. Then, I have added iodine drop. How many drops? 2 drops of iodine solution. Then, we are getting a bluish black PPT. In the second test, I have taken 3 ml of the starch solution. Then I have added 2 drops of alpha naphthol and then concentrated H2SO4. Then in the middle you are getting a ring, that is called ring test. Okay, so that is the practice.